Barnaby Jones, a Quinn Martin production, starring Buddy Ebsen, also starring Lee Merriweather, Mark Shera, with guest stars in alphabetical order, Dabney Coleman, Bradford Dillman, Marge Doucet, Sherry Jackson, Susan Sullivan, Robert Weber. Tonight's episode, Final Judgment.
I've been looking everywhere for you. I should have figured you were probably here all along. Well, now that's a switch.
Ran out of milk.
You know, that's not going to help. I've been there, mister. Remember?
There's a little girl out there. Is dead on account of me.
Well, there's a little girl out there dead because 11 years ago, somebody out there kidnapped the Sayers child and framed Dan. Now, because you're trying to clear Dan, there's a killer out there that's just doing his work again.
I should have been smarter. I should have known it was a frame.
People make mistakes.
Yes, and it hurts to admit them. It hurts to lay them out in the light and look at them.
I know. Look, I have hated you for so many years. I said, well, he doesn't care about us. He can destroy two lives with his testimony. Maybe even he framed Dan. But I never once stopped to think about maybe how you felt about it. I know now that you have probably suffered in your way just as much as we did.
Jennifer. I'm sorry.
Don't apologize to me for being human.
Jones, I'm Laird Crum. Understand you want to see me?
Don't I know you from somewhere?
Yeah, it's possible. My business, you meet a lot of people.
You sure look familiar, Mr. Crum.
What's it about? I'm busy.
Haley Winters.
Haley? Oh, yeah. The singer that I hired from L.A., yeah. Hey, her agent told me what happened. I still can't believe it.
You better believe it. I saw it with my own eyes.
Rotten break. Sweet kid like that? For what? What could she have had on her? A few bucks.
You think it was a mugging?
All I know is what her agent told me. Her wallet was missing. Her suitcase had been busted into. If that wasn't a mugging, what would you call it?
Cold-blooded murder.
Come on. Who'd want to do a thing like that?
She was about to become a witness in a... Leo Krell, here from L.A.
For a while, yeah.
Used to have clubs there.
Yeah, but I don't understand what's...
I may be a little slow on faces, but I never forget a reputation. Especially when it's built on everything from pornography to fencing stolen whiskey.
Look, Jones, I was never convicted on any one of those raps.
No, but compared to the heat you were getting from the L.A. Crime Commission, the Arizona desert must have seemed like Antarctica. That's why you came out here, isn't it?
Mr. Jones, I came out to Arizona like a lot of other people for my health. Maybe you better leave for the same reason, huh?
If that's a threat, Krell, you better watch yourself. Because I may report you to the Chamber of Commerce.
Got it. Thanks, Lieutenant. Now, listen, if there's ever anything I can do for you, be sure to call me, huh? That was the Phoenix police. They've been keeping an eye on Krell ever since he arrived there. According to their intelligence, he's only made one trip back to L.A. He left Phoenix on the 1st of this month and returned on the 5th.
Well, Haley wasn't even appearing at the rendezvous room then.
Then he lied.
Anything in those reports to help you, Barnaby?
Nothing that connects Krell to Haley's murder or the kidnapping, but there are a few names that I'm curious about.
Well, which one?
Tommy Hendricks.
An old pal of Krell's. Krell kept him around for laughs.
Where's he now?
Well, it's a good question. Krell quit laughing when Hendricks decided to go into the fencing business for himself. No one's seen him since.
Nora Reardon.
She used to be Krell's girlfriend till she got messed up on the hard stuff. Last I heard, she's in a rehabilitation center up north.
And then there's the police officer, Gene Gates, whose name runs all the way through the file.
Gates was my sergeant when I was a patrolman. Good cop. He's in there because he was always on Krell's tail. Almost nabbed him a couple of times, too.
Where is Gates now?
Shortly after that, he took a bullet in the hip from a bank holdup. That led to an early retirement. A little later on, he went to work as head of security for the Kingman Company.
The land developers?
Best thing that ever happened to him. He learned the ropes of the business, got some good tips on which land to buy from Kingman himself. Made a bundle in real estate. Funny thing, I saw him just the other day. Looked like $1 million. Some people have all the luck.
That's for sure. John, you happen to have an address on Gates? I'd like to talk to him.
What about?
According to this, he is the only living expert on Leo Krell.
Sweetheart?
Huh?
Gene, Hey, boy, I tell you, it was a scorcher out there today. Listen, when it cools off, maybe you'll come out and shoot around with me. You'd like this course. It's not a bad place. Lemonade, just what the doctor ordered.
Honey, this is Barnaby Jones. He's a private investigator.
Now, Mr. Jones, what can I do for you?
I want to talk to you a little bit about Leo Krell.
Leo Krell? Oh, boy, that's a name out of the past.
According to the police record, you're considered an authority on Krell.
We've had a run-in or two, yeah. What do you want to know about him?
Where he fits into the Sayers kidnapping.
The Sayer kidnapping?
You remember that, Mr. Gates, about 11 years ago, the son of a wealthy real estate dealer?
That's right. Of course, I'd retired from the force by then. I remember reading about it in the paper. What makes you think Krell had anything to do with that?
Well, it's a long, twisting road, and I won't bore you with it. But I had my hands on a witness who could prove that the man that they convicted was innocent. Now, all of a sudden, she's been murdered.
What, you think Krell did it?
No, but I think he was responsible for luring her from the protection of the detective who was guarding her.
Well, have you talked to him about it?
Yes, and would you believe he denied everything?
Yeah, I believe it. I think you're on the wrong track.
Why do you say that?
Well, it's not his method of operations. Loan sharking, prostitution, fencing. That's Krell, not kidnapping, no.
He could have done it as a favor or to repay an old debt.
That's possible. But I doubt it. I still think you're wrong.
Well, it wouldn't be the first time. Thank you very much for the lemonade, Ms. Gates. Mr. Gates.
He knows something, I'm sure of it.
Mr. Kingman, please. Gene Gates speaking. Out of town for how long? I mean, when's he coming back? Yes, tell him it's important.
Gene, I'm afraid.
No, I've never seen him before.
Are you sure? His name is Leo Krell.
I'm positive.
What about this one?
I don't know. Something familiar about him. Who is he?
His name is Gene Gates. He was a police officer.
Well, that's probably it. I mean, when they arrested me, there were cops all over the place.
He wouldn't have been there. He retired before the kidnapping.
Damn it, this. I know him from somewhere.
Think, Dan. It's important.
Gates. Wait a minute. His name isn't Gates. It was Masters, Joe Masters. And he never said anything about being a retired cop. He told me he was into...
private security work?
No. He was into cars. He told me he sold auto parts.
Where did you meet him?
At a bowling alley I used to go to. The Echo Park Lanes on Sunset. He was in there one night and we started talking. I saw him a few times after and we had a couple of beers together.
You tell him a lot about yourself, your work, Jennifer?
Yeah, sure. What else is there to talk about?
Tell him about your cabin up on the lake?
Yeah. I even invited him to come up fishing some weekend.
Did he ever come?
No, I never got the chance. I got arrested about a month later for the kidnapping. Jones, you think this guy had something to do with framing me?
I would say there's a very strong possibility, but don't ask me how we prove it.
Well, it's about time. We've got things to talk about. I'm trying to call you all evening. Don't you ever check your service?
My plane landed just a few minutes ago. What's wrong?
That private detective, Barnaby Jones, was by to see me today. He knows about Krell.
Knows?
Well, suspects. If he finds out that Krell owed me because I shut my eyes when he escaped in that raid, we're dead.
What else does he know?
Well, I don't know. Maybe he was just fishing around.
And then again, maybe he wasn't. You want us to take that chance?
Us? Oh, I love the way we share your problem, but I get stuck with the dirty end of the stick.
That's right, Gene. Nothing has changed. Unless, of course, you don't care anymore. I mean, how this all turns out.
I'll take care of Mr. Jones for you.
Barnaby, Gates was once a detective. If he wanted to frame someone, he'd sure know how to do it.
I can't argue against that.
And there's the $20 of the ransom money that Rhodes spent. He said he was bowling a few nights before and that he always left his wallet in his locker. All Gates would have had to do is just, you know, open the locker and put some money in.
But why?
$430,000 has never been recovered.
Jedediah, what kind of a person resorts to kidnapping?
Poor. Ignorant. Desperate.
Was Gates any of these?
Well, he certainly wasn't poor. Between his police retirement and his pay from Kingman, he was making over $20,000 a year.
That's the equivalent of $35,000 today. Does that sound like your ordinary run-of-the-mill kidnapper?
No, Barnaby, it doesn't. Unless he had another reason other than the ransom money.
Now you're making sense, Jedediah.
You have any idea where we should start?
Mrs. Gates, what a pleasant surprise.
Mr. Jones.
I don't think you ever met my associate, Jedediah Romano Jones.
Nice to meet you.
How you do?
We're just on our way to the bookstore. I bet I know where you just came from. The beauty parlor.
Yes.
Something about a woman who just had her hair done that shows in every part of her face, like spring bursting forth through winter.
Well, that's very nice, Mr. Jones. Well, if you'll excuse me. Nice meeting you. Excuse me.
Well, since we've run into each other like this, how about a cup of coffee?
I'm afraid I don't have the time.
Well, the coffee shop's just right over there. We want to ask you a couple of questions, you know.
I really don't think we have anything to talk about.
Well, you won't know until you hear what we have to say.
I'm afraid I have to meet my husband, Mr. Jones.
That's what I want to talk about. Why did he kidnap the Sayer child?
What did you say?
Which part didn't you hear, Mrs. Gates? Why did he kidnap the Sayer child?
How dare you?
Was it just for the money?
You think my husband...
engineered the kidnapping and framed Dan Rhodes, yeah.
You're both crazy.
The facts speak for themselves. Shortly after Rhodes' conviction, your husband quit his job with Kingman. The two of you got married, spent an extended honeymoon in Europe, and came back and bought that big house.
Where did he suddenly get that kind of money? What did he do, win the Irish sweepstakes or something?
From his investments. Mr. Kingman advised him about some property, and it paid off.
Does your husband still like to bowl?
My husband never liked to bowl. The only game he plays is golf.
And I suppose he never used the name Joe Masters?
No, of course not.
That's funny, because Rhodes identified a picture of your husband as Joe Masters, somebody he once met in a bowling alley.
Well, he's a liar.
You know, Linda, I think we've got you all wrong. Jedediah, I'm beginning to suspect that this is a classic case of the unwilling accomplice. A lady who is forced into a crime by the man she loves.
And all these years, she's had it on her conscience, but she didn't say anything because she was afraid to go to jail.
Now, Linda, you cooperate with us, and we'll try our best to help you.
The only thing I want from you, Mr. Jones, is to be left alone.
Well, if he didn't do it for the money, was it because he owed someone a favor? Was he working for someone?
Look, my husband worked only for Mr. Kingman. He was loyal to Mr. Kingman and owed nothing to anyone.
Well, if she's supposed to be the weakest link, Barnaby, sure hate to run up against the strongest.
Don't be too sure, Jedediah. I think we got two.
There you are. Why are you so late? Hey, what's the matter?
Jones was waiting for me when I got out.
What did he want?
He wanted to know why you kidnapped the child. Jeannie knows everything. All he needs is the proof.
Betty said you were looking for me. I've been out making deliveries all day.
Yeah, I imagine this is your busy time of the year.
Yeah, it gets pretty hectic. Listen, I'm sorry about those things I said to you the other day.
It's all right. We were probably both a little hot under the collar.
Yeah, I guess we were. What do you want to see me about?
You know this man?
No, who's he?
Gene Gates.
No, doesn't mean anything to me.
He's a former police officer, and then he became head of security for Kingman Development Company.
Kingman? Where does he fit into this?
You know Gordon Kingman?
Oh, yeah, we go way back.
How?
I owned the original option on all that land down at the marina. Of course, at that time it was a swamp, but I saw the potential of it.
You sold it to Kingman?
No, I didn't sell it to him. He wanted it so much he could taste it. When he found out he couldn't get it from me, why, he tried everything he could to get it away from me. Legal maneuvers, dirty tricks, all kinds of harassment.
That's very interesting.
Yeah, I hung in as long as I could, and then... Well, you know the rest.
Your son was kidnapped.
Right. I borrowed the money from the bank for the ransom. I had to put up the option from the marina land as collateral. Of course, when the money wasn't recovered, why, I lost everything. It wasn't just the money, though, you know. I'm sure I could have raised the money and saved the land, gone on with my plans to build, but when my son wasn't returned, why, something just died inside of me. I just wanted to close the door and walk away from everything. That's what I did.
So Kingman finally got what he wanted. Something he couldn't get any other way.
You think Kingman was involved in the kidnapping?
It all suddenly begins to make a kind of a terrible sense, doesn't it?
I can't believe a man would go that far. But...
get out!
See who it was?
No, but I got a pretty good idea. I think I hit him. The way he's bleeding, he shouldn't be too hard to find.
Barnaby, are you all right?
It stings a little, smarts a little. Other than that, it's fine. How'd you hear about it?
Well, when I didn't hear from you, I called Betty and she told me what happened.
I'm afraid I'm going to have to give you a rain check on that dinner. I've got important work to do.
Barnaby, don't you think that you should take it a little easy? I mean, remember what the doctor said.
Doctor didn't say anything about taking it easy. Just don't swing from a trapeze for a while.
Just talked to Lieutenant Biddle.
Yeah? What'd you tell him?
Well, I told him you were nicked by an unknown assailant.
Did he buy it?
I sounded a little suspicious, but he was relieved to know you were all right. Told him we'd keep him informed.
Good. That's all he needs to know for a while.
Well, now what are you going to do?
Well, if I remember correctly, there is an ex-cop out there somewhere. We've got a lot of explaining to do. We're going to find him.
Barnaby, I'm going with you, and I don't want an argument.
He's arguing. Now, don't forget about that dinner.
Get it done. Just take good care of yourself.
I'm sorry, Mr. Gates isn't home.
What about Mrs. Gates?
She isn't here either.
That's funny, her car's in the driveway.
She went with Mr. Gates in his car.
Millie, you make fine lemonade, but you're a terrible liar.
Millie? That's all right. You can let them in. Thank you. She isn't lying to you, gentlemen. My husband isn't home.
Well, where is he?
He had to meet someone. Business.
You sure he's not meeting a doctor?
A doctor?
You mean you don't know?
Know what? What are you talking about?
Somebody took a couple of shots at me today. I shot back and hit him. I think it was your husband.
Well, you're wrong. You're wrong.
Then you've seen him in the last few hours?
Yes. We had dinner together. He was fine.
Then why are you shaking like that?
I am shaking because you have upset me.
I think you're upset because you haven't heard from your husband all afternoon and you're wondering why. If he's still conscious, he's probably hiding someplace waiting for the doctor to arrive.
No.
I also discovered why he kidnapped the Sayers child. It wasn't for money. It was to break Ted Sayers.
And so Kingman wouldn't be suspected he framed Rhodes.
That's not true.
It is true. And I'm going to get you all for kidnapping and murder.
Murder? Just because somebody was kidnapped does not mean that they were murdered. They never found a body.
Are you saying that that child wasn't killed, that he's still alive somewhere?
No, I'm...
Then what are you saying?
I don't know. I'm not saying anything.
Is that child still alive? Tell us, please.
I don't know. I told you, I don't know. Now, would you please go away? Just go away!
I know it's not my cooking that turns you on, but it's not that bad, is it?
No, it's just fine.
Then what's wrong?
What makes you think anything?
The way you've been acting. Gordon, is it over? Us?
No.
You're sure? I mean, you'd tell me if it was, wouldn't you?
That's one thing you don't ever have to worry about. It's just business. It'll all be taken care of soon. Jean.
Get rid of her. Get rid of her.
I'll meet you back at the apartment, huh?
Okay, don't be late.
You look terrible. What's wrong?
That.
My God, what happened?
Jones. I got hit.
Did you get him?
No, he got away.
And you came here?
What did you expect me to do? It's a bullet wound. You want me to check into a hospital?
What do you expect me to do about it?
Get me some help. And you'd better start doing some of your own dirty work for a change. I'm not going down for this alone, I promise you.
All right. All right, Gene. Just relax. Look, you caught me off guard, that's all. It just so happens I know a good doctor. He'll fix you up in no time. Here, let me get you a drink.
Oh, let's get through to Linda. I didn't call her myself. I didn't know what Jones was up to. And I don't want her to worry.
I'll take care of it for you. You know, you and I have always been partners in this thing, Gene. Oh, even more than that. More than partners. Friends. I've always taken good care of you. I won't let you down now.
Yes?
Is Mr. Kingman in?
No, he isn't.
Have any idea where we can find him?
Any idea where who can find him?
Well, I'm sorry. My name is Barnaby Jones. I'm a private investigator. This is my associate, Jedediah Jones. And you are?
Erica Hughes. I'm a friend of Mr. Kingman. But I don't know where he is. I suggest you try him at the office tomorrow.
Barnaby, will you look at the view of the city?
I bet you'd much rather have a look around the apartment, wouldn't you? Well, go right ahead. He's not here. The bedrooms are that way.
Anyone makes that generous an offer, I'm inclined to believe them. And you haven't seen Mr. Kingman tonight?
No. In fact, I just got here myself.
You mind telling us where you were?
Out to dinner.
Dressed like that?
It's called casual. Although I did wear both shoes. Do you mind if I make the other foot comfortable?
You know, Miss Hughes, the way you're dressed, I almost suspect you had dinner on a boat. And Mr. Kingman does have a boat, doesn't he?
No, he has a yacht, but he's not on it.
Really? How do you know?
Look, if I tell you where he is, will you go away?
We just want to find him.
We did have dinner together, but not on his yacht. At his house in Malibu. You knew he had a house there, didn't you?
It was next on our list.
Well, that's where he is.
Thank you. Oh, one more thing. Does Mr. Kingman know someone named Jean Gates?
No, is he a friend?
Sort of. I suspect they both came out from under the same rock.
Yes?
Gordon, Barnaby Jones was just here looking for you.
What'd you tell him?
I told him you were at the beach house.
He believe you?
I don't know. I think he's suspicious about the boat.
I'll talk to you later.
Where's the doctor?
That was him on the phone, Jane. He's on his way now.
Linda, did you get in touch with Linda?
Everything's been taken care of. It's all over, Jane. You have nothing more to worry about.
Mr. Kingman?
Yes?
My name is Barnaby Jones. I'm a private investigator. This is my associate, Jedediah Jones. Can we talk with you?
Come aboard.
Thank you. Nice boat you got here.
Thank you. What did you want to talk to me about?
Why did your girlfriend lie to us last night?
Lie? Erica?
I know that's hard to believe, Mr. Kingman, but you told us you were at your house in Malibu.
Well, I was. Then I decided to take the boat out.
By yourself?
You don't see anyone else aboard, do you?
Isn't it a little unusual for a boat this size?
Not at all. It has automatic pilot, radar, electronic navigation equipment. You know, sometimes I feel that I'm the most useless thing aboard.
Where did you go?
Catalina headed back around sunrise. Look, just what is this all about?
Well, it's about your partner, Gene Cage.
My partner? You're a little confused, aren't you? I mean, Gene worked for me, but he was never my partner.
Have you seen him recently?
Oh, we bump into each other now and then, but that's about it. Tell me, what is your interest in Gene?
Well, you remember the Stairs kidnapping, don't you, Mr. Kingman?
Oh, yes, a real tragedy.
Yeah, well, we think he was the kidnapper.
Gene. I don't believe it.
Well, when you hear this, we think you paid him to do it.
That's a very serious charge, Mr. Jones. I take it you're prepared to prove it.
Well, I'd be more prepared if I could find Gene Gates, but I'm afraid that's impossible now.
And why not?
Because I think you killed him and buried him at sea.
I think you better get off my boat, Jones. If you have anything else to say, you can talk to my lawyers.
Well, you talk to your lawyers. If I have anything else to say, I'll be talking to the police.
Morning.
What is it, Jones?
Looks like fresh blood, Mr. King.
Yes? On my way back this morning, I decided to try my luck. Bonita.
One of these days, your luck will run out.
to now?
Only place we have left to go.
The weakest link?
She must be worried sick about her husband. If she doesn't crack now, she never will.
Hello?
Linda, Gordon Kingman.
Gordon, where is Gene? I haven't heard from him since yesterday.
He's all right, but he has been wounded.
Oh, no. And Jones wasn't lying.
Linda, he's going to be fine. I've got him in a safe place.
Gordon, I want to go to him.
Well, of course, that's why I called. I'm planning to fly him to a hospital in Mexico. Now, how long do you think it would take you to get ready?
Just a few minutes.
Fine. Then I tell you what you do. You take a cab to Crescent Salvage. That's at the bottom of E Street in the harbor. Have you got that?
Yeah, fine.
Fine. And you better hurry, Linda, because I'm sure that Jones is on his way to your place now.
Miss Gates home?
No, she's not here.
That's what you told us last night, Millie.
This time she really isn't.
Why is your car here?
She left by cab. That's the truth, not more than 5 minutes ago.
Do you know where she went?
I don't know. She got a call, packed a small suitcase, and left.
Did you see what kind of a cab it was?
Yes, a red line.
All right, I'll get on it. Can I use your phone?
I guess so.
Thank you.
Hey, I'm really sorry about getting lost back there, ma'am. But this part of town ain't exactly my territory.
It's quite all right.
Now, if you'd like to maybe knock off a couple of bucks.
Okay, thank you.
I'll be right down. Come ahead, I'll meet you.
Gordon, where is he?
I told him not to worry. He's fine.
He's not here, is he?
No, I had him moved just a few minutes ago. I had him taken to a private airfield. My plane is there.
Well, then we better hurry.
Linda, wait. Who's that?
Well, this is the address a radio dispatcher gave me.
It's the one, all right.
Kingman Company.
It's Jones. He must have followed you here somehow. Come on.
There's a way out back.
Linda!
Gene's waiting.
Barnaby, they're right there.
are you taking her, Kingman?
Jones, I told you. If you have anything more to say, contact my lawyers.
You know where your husband is, Linda?
I know he's all right.
My guess is he's dead. He buried him at sea last night.
He's lying, Linda.
With you out of the way, there's no one left to tie him to your husband's murder or the kidnapping.
If Gene is all right, why hasn't he tried to get in touch with me?
Linda, come on.
No, wait a minute.
All right, Jones.
Oh, my God, then it's true. Gene's dead.
Your gun, Jones. Come on.
Call the police.
There's still a chance, Linda. Without your testimony, they have nothing.
You really think that I would...
But you'll be implicating yourself, too, in everything.
No. No, my only crime is having kept quiet.
The Sayers' child, Linda, he's still alive, isn't he?
Yes. He was just so helpless, and Gene and I kept him hidden for a while, and then we drove him up to Oregon and put him up for adoption as if he were our own child.
Oh, what do you know about that?
What time did Betty say they'd get here?
Plane got in an hour ago. Should be here any minute.
Yeah. That was very nice of her to fly all the way up to Portland and pick him up for this little visit.
Well, she figured that his adopted parents would feel a lot safer if there was a woman around in case he got an upset stomach from all those hot dogs you're gonna buy him.
How'd you know about the hot dogs?
Ted, these adopted parents of Stevie's, they're the only parents he's ever known. He loves them.
No, I know, Barnaby. I don't expect any miracles here. You know, I just want us to get to know each other again and see him once in a while, you know?
I don't think he'll have any problem.
Barnaby? Mr. Sayers.
Hi.
Oh, God, I mean, he's a lot bigger than I thought he was.
He's 13.
You have to be hungry, though, I guess. Are you hungry?
Yeah.
You want a hot dog?
Kind of like hamburgers more.
I love hamburgers. Want to go get a hamburger?
Yeah.
Thank you. How was the plane ride?
Don't go cry.
One of you ready?
For what?
Well, I thought you wanted to drive up to the lake this afternoon and go fishing.
Great idea. I gotta make one stop for.
Okay.
You fellas drop me off. I took a cab to the airport.
Sure will.
I'll be right back.
Sorry I'm late.
It doesn't matter. Well, what's the news?
I just talked to Dan's lawyer. The wheels are in motion for his release. It shouldn't be long now.
I'm so happy for Dan.
What about you?
I don't know. I just don't know.
Dan needs all the breaks he can get now.
It's just that we've been apart for so long.
But you can change all that in a day. In an hour.
Do you think after all I've been through that he'd still want me?
Yes, I do. Let's take a walk down by the lagoon. Talk about plans for you and Dan. Maybe there's some way I can help.
JR, did you really want to go fishing?
What, are you kidding? I hate fishing. I did it for Barnaby.
You know, we're really very lucky to have you.
Yeah, maybe you're right.